Hey guys, so I have a fill-in haul that I'm going to share with you. If you remember from my last haul, I said that I had to go back to Costco just to get a couple of items that I'm going to need before the month was over. Well, it's now December 1st, so I went back to Costco, kind of stocked up on a couple of things, and then I also went to Pequeño Mundo, and I did get a couple of random items from a few different places, so I'll share that with you as well. So everything right here is from Costco. All right, so first thing that's not actually from Costco is this mat. I got this at the hardware store. But then at Costco, which is, again, I've mentioned PriceSmart for us, but it is a Costco affiliate. So I picked up some Pringles just to have on hand. This is the 4 variety pack. I got some mayonnaise. That's mainly what I needed to get, mayonnaise and almond milk. So I got some mayonnaise. They did not have this in stock the last time I went. Some more of the artisanal hamburger buns. I am going to go to Walmart tomorrow or Friday, and I'm going to pick up some regular bread. I'm going to stock back up on that because we're running low, and some cereal. I got the hamburger buns. Today, like I mentioned, is December 1st, so it is the start of Advent, and they don't sell the Advent chocolate boxes here. At least they stopped selling them. So I did this 1 year, and this was really, really good. These cookies are bomb. So I picked up another container of the European cookies. So what the kids will do is every day in December, they'll open this up, and they'll pick a cookie for their Advent. So I got that. I got another 4-pack of the tropical drink mixes. This comes with the strawberry and watermelon lemonade. This is really good. So I wanted to make sure that we had more on hand. And then this is something that I'm trying, the pain au chocolat. I don't know if this is new, but I don't think I've seen it at Costco. I've seen it at Auto Mercado. So I wanted to go ahead and give this a try. I think the kids might like that as well. Just warm this up and then have it for like breakfast in the mornings. I think that would be pretty delicious. More Alfredo sauce, because y'all know how long I went without Alfredo sauce, you guys. So I wanted to go ahead and stock back up. And then the Caribbean style beef and chicken patties. They had the mixture for the first time. Usually I get 1 pack of beef, 1 pack of chicken. They did not have just chicken, so I thought the mixture would be a better option for our family since my middle son does not eat the beef one. So I got that. I got some of the Havarti and Gouda cheese snack. The last time I got this was a while ago, because this is actually pretty pricey. But since I haven't gotten it in such a long time, I decided to go ahead and pick up another pack. This comes with 12 Havarti bars and the 12 Gouda cheese bars. I know the kids are going to like this for a little snack. And then I also got some more salmon because 1 pack just is not enough. I already took it out of the packaging. They're individually packaged in here. So I took it out and I put it in the freezer. And then I also got another bag of the variety pack of the Lay's Classic Mix, just so the kids can have snacks, because we are running low on snacks already, believe it or not. And then back here, like I mentioned, I needed to get some more almond beverage. This is the milk that we drink, so I don't like to run out. We have 1 carton left in the refrigerator, so I had to stock back up. So that was everything from Costco. And then this is what I got from Pequeño Mundo. I saw that they had the Ritz toasted chips in the sour cream. So I got that. I wanted to get some potatoes and tomatoes, so I did get that. I also wanted to get some kiwi. I wanted to get some cupcakes. And I wanted to get some ding-dongs just to stock back up. And then I also got some spaghetti and some wipes. Tomorrow at Walmart, I will pick up some onions because we completely ran out of onions. And in my household, we always have to be stocked on onions. And then at the mall, I went to Bath & Body Works because they're having their sale. And so I got 2 of the candles. Candles are bomb, you guys. I'm running out of the one that I have right now. So I got the mahogany teak wood. I know I really like this. And this was all right, but I wanted to give it a try to see how it smells when it's burning. So I got the marshmallow fireside. And then also at the mall, at like a novelty store. I got the kids these peppermint sticks, like candy canes, for our hot chocolate tonight because, like I mentioned, it is December 1st, the start of Advent, and we always kick off our start to the holiday season or the start to the Christmas season with the Polar Express and hot chocolate and marshmallows and candy canes and popcorn. So I wanted to get that, and this is like a big, thick piece of peppermint, so I might actually be splitting that in half, so we'll have some leftovers. But that's everything I picked up today. Like I mentioned, tomorrow at Walmart, I will be getting bread, cereal, and onions. I finally changed what it says on my letterboard, because what I had up here before, I had it up here for over a year, so it was time to change and 'tis the season. So I have what it says now on my letterboard, which is Christmas is the most wonderful time of year. Am I right? I'm right, right? Love it. We're gonna go ahead now and start our countdown to Advent. We're gonna have our hot chocolate, our popcorn, and watch the Polar Express. Kids already picked their chocolate treat for the first day of Advent. The countdown has begun. Alright guys, so let me come on and do a quick voiceover. I hope you've been enjoying the vlog so far. These are just a couple of random clips that I've taken throughout the holiday season so far. Mainly because obviously I'm doing this for my kids and just to make the season a little bit more magical. And of course it's all about making memories, right? So this was one of the first like treat activities that we did for Christmas. We decorated Christmas cookies, and these cookies I actually bought at a specialty supermarket. So I remember last year we did sugar cookies where we cut out the shapes and everything, and that was super fun. But to make it just a little bit quicker and a lot easier, I bought the cookies. They were already baked, they already had their shapes, and so all we had to do, because it came with the icing and the sprinkles, was decorate our cookies, and the kids had so much fun doing this. I know my kids are a little bit older, but they still do like doing things like this, you know what I mean? Treats, making the memories for the holiday season. So this was one of the activities that we did. You'll see later on in this vlog that we did end up baking sugar cookies, just normal drop sugar cookies. And we also decorated those as well. But this was just something super simple, pretty quick for us to do for the holiday season. Anyway, let's get back to the video and the vlog. And I hope you are enjoying watching. All right, guys, I'm going to share a small fill-in haul. I wouldn't even call this a fill-in. This is mostly stuff that I picked up for treats and also for dinner tonight. So treats over here, I picked up my O. Henry bar because they didn't have the Nutrageous, and then kisses because we're going to be making our peanut butter blossoms, needed kisses for those. And then my son's school, they're asking the parents to go ahead and donate this specific brand of chocolate. So I got the mint one, and it was on sale today. So I got two of those. Bread to have as backup because we're running low. And then I saw this, and I really wanted to give it a try, even though it was pretty expensive. But we've been watching a Christmas movie every single night. It's like part of our Christmas season tradition. And the kids especially like to have a treat. So I went ahead and got this as our treat tonight, the peppermint bark. Looks really good. For dinner tonight, actually right now, because I am going to be busy. My 8-year-old has a dentist appointment at 3:30, and that's like gonna be busy, busy, busy time for me. So I won't have time to come back and make dinner. So I'm cooking early today. I got burgers, I have buns already, I have lettuce, I have cheese. So I got burgers, and then I got these cheese stuffed or cheese filled yuca balls. And then I got yogurt to put in the fridge for snacking, some more eggnog because, you know, tis the season. They haven't had this in stock in a minute, so I picked up a sparkling ice, the coconut pineapple flavor, because that's my favorite. And then I used to get these all the time, so whenever I see them and I remember, I pick them up for the kids. These are the probiotic strawberry, like, liquid yogurt. Kind of like a Go-Gurt. I freeze these for the kids. And then I got some coleslaw for dinner tonight to go with the burgers. And y'all already know I had to pick up the Florida's Natural Blackberry Lemonade. And that's everything I got from Walmart. So here is something else that we did for the holiday season. In our town, they were doing a mini parade. And so all we had to do was just stand outside on our main street and watch the parade pass us by. It was super simple. It wasn't like over the top, but it was super sweet that the town put together this little parade. They even tossed out candies for the kids, which was really nice. So this was something else that we did for the holidays. The holiday season this year is a little bit different. There aren't a lot going on. Well, there aren't a lot of activities going on, and there really isn't that much to do. So whenever something comes up, I really like to go ahead and participate with my kids because, again, like I mentioned, it's all about making those memories. So this was in our town, and then in our city, in the downtown area, they decorated the park. And so I decided to go ahead and take the kids there. We made like a little night of it. It was so fun. We were able to walk around the park, take some pictures. I think this was the first year that they've done anything like this. And I know it's super popular because it's all over Facebook, and depending on when you go, the lines can be super long. We lucked out the first entrance and the line wasn't that long, so we were able to go in, take our pictures, sightsee a little bit, and then afterwards I treated the kids to a few fun treats. They had like these food trucks outside the park. So another simple but fun activity to do with the kids for the holiday season that is memorable as well.
Yeah. So after we were done at the park, we went ahead, drove around, and looked at all the houses that were decorated for Christmas. In our town, there were two houses in particular that are super famous for their decorations, so I was really happy that we were able to see those two houses. And then, this is the last clip for this vlog. We went ahead and baked sugar cookies. We didn't, like I mentioned, cut out shapes this year because we'd already kind of done something like that earlier in the month. So we just baked them. Well, I baked them off, and then the kids were able to go in and decorate and put whatever designs they wanted on their cookies. And again, this is something that is so simple. This was a mix that I bought at the supermarket on clearance. It took no time at all to mix this up together. It basically took like 7 minutes in the oven to bake, and the kids had so much fun putting their designs and decorating each cookie that they were going to eat that night. So again, something super simple that we were able to do to kind of commemorate the season and create memories for our family. And again, sugar cookies are delicious. So after we were done decorating, we were able to also enjoy them as an evening treat. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. Thank you so much for watching, and I will talk to you in my next video. Bye.